Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. So in today's video, we're going to talk very quickly about the Blackmagic announcement from IBC, which were yesterday. And basically what Blackmagic did announce, they did not announce one camera, but actually announced three cameras, or basically it was more or less four, but we'll come back to that. Of course, there were the usual announcements about switchers, and for some people that is super interesting, but for me, I'm more into the cameras and the software and cool updates. So for me, the thing to take away from the press conference was that, so first up, we're going to have a new version of the studio camera. I haven't used a studio camera like this before. It is the Blackmagic Studio Camera 4K Plus G2, second generation. And it has some new features and stuff like that. Looks cool, but I've never used a studio camera. I'm more into the pocket cameras and the old school cameras. Also, which is actually coming back, is the Micro Studio Camera G2. It was that little cube thing they did a while back, and they haven't produced those for a while, but now they are back with a new sleek design, and hopefully that could be useful for studio work, but also just for cameras to place very odd places, because it is a tiny camera compared to like an Ursa or the, you know, 6K Pro, which is a kind of a big camera. So now we come to the big camera announcement. That was the Blackmagic Cinema Camera 6K, and it is a full frame camera with an L mount. But of course, L mounts can be adapted to EF and all sorts of lenses with adapters. It looks pretty cool. It looks very similar to the cinema camera, the pocket cinema camera 6K, like this. It has the same flip out screen like this one has. It is not as wide as this camera. It is kind of smaller because of that mount. And really, it is. It looks very interesting, I think. One thing missing from that camera is the internal NDs, which I love on the Pro camera. It is so nice to have internal NDs, but that's not going to be in the new 6K version. However, the full frame are really going to give it a more cinematic look, I think, but that is a totally different discussion and not really that relevant for this video. The last thing, and actually maybe that might be the thing that camera-wise that surprised me the most and got me the most excited. It is not actually a camera, it is a it's an app for your iPhone. And that is actually the app running on the iPhone, the Blackmagic camera app, which is a super cool thing. I think you can see here we have the operating system, you know, from Blackmagic cameras. It's super cool, and you can turn it around like this and it will follow. It's one of the modes it has. It is a super cool thing. One of the things I always find troublesome when shooting on your iPhone is that, you know, there is a bunch of different camera apps, but they all look the same. And, you know, for me, coming back to a Blackmagic, or at least making a lot of shots with Blackmagic cameras, the menu system of this just feels so nice. And all of the features are here. Really, really a very cool. And the cool thing about this app, if you haven't tried a Blackmagic camera before, or you haven't worked with Blackmagic cameras before and you want to try out the menu system, because that is one of the greatest menu systems in any camera, hands down, it is really good. You can try it out on your iPhone, and it's absolutely a free app to download from the App Store. Pretty cool. I think it's going to be fun. It also has some different features that Blackmagic also did announce. They did announce they're going to have a cloud storage system. So in theory, you can, on shooting on this camera and also on the new camera that's going to be available, you can shoot a clip and it's going to generate a proxy and upload that to the cloud. And then you can sync that together with DaVinci Resolve, meaning that as soon as you have done a clip, it's going to upload that, and somebody else anywhere in the world that's in that project can actually edit your footage before you come home from the shoot. It's really, really amazing. I think it's pretty cool. And talking about DaVinci Resolve, of course, there is also a new update for DaVinci Resolve. That is DaVinci Resolve 18.6. And that's just going to make those features available with the syncing and cloud storage and all of that. And there is probably also some bug fixes and stuff like that, small things, but I haven't really looked into that yet. But the update for DaVinci Resolve is here as well. Well, that was a long ramble about what I saw in the IBC video the other day. So hopefully you find this little video useful. And if you did, please hit that subscribe button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.